Hello. In this video, we're going to learn how to use Java JDBC to insert data into a database. As far as the prep work that you need to have taken care of, you need to make sure that you have a database already installed. In this example, we're going to use MySQL. Also, you need to make sure you have the JDBC driver installed for your database. In this example, we're going to make use of a very simple table called employees. This table is going to have four columns. It's going to have the ID, the last name, the first name, and the email address. Now let's take a look at this table in our SQL query tool. In this example, I have the employees table. I ran a select star against that table. And I have my output. So we have three employees in the database right now: John Doe, Mary Public, and Susan Q. Now, if we wanted to actually insert data into the database, we could use a query tool and we could use the statement here: insert into employees, specify the columns, last name, first name, email, and then the actual values. What we're going to do is take this information and actually use it in a Java program. So our basic development process is first getting a connection to a database, second, creating a statement, and third, executing the SQL insert. So let's move over to our Java development tool. So in this application, it's a very simple project. And what we need to do first is get a connection to a database. Okay, so we'll have driver manager get connection. We give the URL, the user ID, and the password. Okay, once we have a connection to the database, then we can create a statement. Okay, so I'll say mycon.create statement, and it gives me a blank statement object. Okay, now that I have a statement, I can set up my SQL. So the SQL, I'll assign it to a string variable, and it's the same SQL we saw in the previous slide. Insert into employees, I give the last name, first name, email, and then I also provide the values, Brown for last name, David, and then that person's email address. Now that I have the SQL, I make use of this statement here, mystatement.executeUpdate. And I pass in a SQL. So this will actually execute this SQL code against the database. And then when I'm finished, I'll just do a system out print line, insert complete, and then I have my normal exception handler for the code. All right. So let's go ahead and save this and let's run it as a Java application. So I'll say execute. And note at the bottom it says insert complete. So now we can go through and actually check this against our database. And if I run the query one more time, and now I can see the statement or the new entry here for our new employee, David Brown at foo.com. So we were successful. Okay. So let's go ahead and wrap up. We were able to insert data into a database using Java JDBC. And if you'd like the code examples or more video tutorials, then visit lovetocode.com.